For Spain's Prime Minister, it was a night to celebrate.
The Socialist Party has won the general election, and with that, the future has won, and the past has lost.
Pedro Sanchez's Socialist Party gained seats in what was one of Spain's most hotly contested elections in decades. But with 29% of the vote, it fell short of a majority. And that will mean weeks, possibly months, of political horse trading ahead, with the Socialists looking either to left-wing Podemos for support or trying to garner backing from regional parties, which could include Catalan separatists. Sanchez declared the result a boost for the European Union. But for the first time since military rule ended in Spain in the 1970s, a far-right party is set to enter parliament. The new Vox movement has promised to defend Spain from its enemies, including feminists, liberal elites, and Muslims.
This is just the beginning. We told you we were initiating a reconquest, and that is exactly what we have done. A reconquest that has put a voice in parliament. And that's where I can say clearly to all of Spain that Vox is here to stay.
Vox is now Spain's fifth largest party, receiving 10% of the vote and gaining 24 seats in parliament, echoing political trends across Europe, where traditional parties have ceded ground to anti-immigration and Eurosceptic forces.
At last, we have a voice in parliament. It is true that we are worried because the left wing is here. They have the majority. But I still consider it a victory for Vox.
Since I was born, I have been proud of being Spanish. From the day I am born to the day that I die, I don't care about votes. I'm here for Spain, not for Vox.
Vox did not do well enough to get the kingmaker role it was hoping for, but the party's rise will likely lead to some nervousness ahead of European Parliament elections next month. When those elections come round, Pedro Sanchez could still be battling to form a government. Coalition building can be a painfully slow business. Michelle Clifford, Sky News, Brussels.